Hello guys, welcome back to the Sports Story. We are here back again with the Unsung Sporting Tales. And in the first couple of episodes, we have had some fantastic stories to hear too. And we are going to have even more fantastic representatives from the sporting industry coming on. And we have one of them amongst us today. Her name is Mrudul. This is your host, Prathamesh. And this is a real proud moment for me to say that I have one of my good friends and really inspiring football player with me. Mrudul Shinde is a national level football player and she's played as a forward. She's a certified AIFF D-licensed coach and she's closely working with grassroots and football. She also has other certifications by the Premier League and FIFA. And football runs through her veins like most of us and we are delighted to have her here. Hi Mrudul, how are you doing?
Hi, I'm good. How are you?
Doing well. Lockdown has been treating us a little, not in the best way possible, but it's okay. You know, we are the little bore sports watchers. For someone like you, you know, who likes to have the ball on her feet almost every day and likes to play outside, this would have been a huge step back, wouldn't it?
Yeah, huge step back. Like, can't even imagine I have been at home like since last 4 or 5 months. I think I would have never imagined I will be at home this long.
So, I don't think anybody imagined this coming up at all, but you know, it's a battle which we are going through right now, and it's good to see that, you know, all of us are doing well and keeping up with pace. Good to see you after a long time too. So, you know, football has been a part of parcel of most of our lives, including mine. For you, you have been following it professionally, but what was your first ever memory of playing the sport and how do you get inspired from that?
So, actually, I used to play in my society when I was in second or third standard. So, it was like just a fun game for me. And I used to play with all the boys and all. So, yeah, I still remember playing in my society. Then when I got into high school, when I was in 6th or 7th standard, that time I saw some girls playing football on our school ground. And we had a female and men's football team at our high school. So, yeah, that's when I thought, why don't I give it a try, you know, to join the team. So that's how I started playing football, like from my high school team, like professionally, that's how I started.
I think it's really good you gave it a try because you have seen over the years what has unfolded in your story. Growing up, obviously, you were inspired by these events, but you might have also had a player that you actually look forward to. So who was that for you?
So while growing up, I have seen Beckham playing. I have seen Cristiano and Neymar at their peak. I have seen David Villa at their peak, at his peak level. So there were so many footballers who I used to follow, but most probably I used to follow Cristiano and Messi. And if I have to choose, I will choose Messi because I have been the biggest fan of Lionel Messi. So, yeah, I follow him big time.
I think only somebody who doesn't understand football would not choose Messi in terms of, you know, it's difficult to separate Ronaldo Messi, to be honest, not at all possible. But I think it's those two that have really brought football on the map for most people growing up like us, because when we were young, we started like Ronaldo, and so our age of watching football and Ronaldo coming up was at the same time. Then Messi came on at some time when we started really understanding football, and then now they're just something else. And you know, we have grown up watching them, so for us it's obviously a pleasure to see those two players. And coming back to your passion for football. So, I haven't personally encountered a lot of people, even during my life, who have played women's football a lot in India. It is still growing. It is still pretty new. You have seen players like Aditi Chauhan, who have done so well in the international stage. Now, Bala has made a move to Rangers. But yeah. this is still an evolving sport for women in India.
Yes.
So
yes.
when you were young, how did that family support really kick in and how great was that to have behind you?
So actually, both of my parents are sportsmen. My mom used to play national level weightlifting and basketball and cricket at the same time. Then my father used to play badminton and table tennis on university level. So it was never a problem for me to join any sport. So they were like very supportive for that. When actually one time was there when I was in 10th standard when the board exam was over there. And and every parent will be like this, you know, that board exam hai, abhi thoda break le lo. So my parents yeah. also said that to me. So for 2 days, I was starving. I wanted to go on the ground. So yeah, that was the only one time they, you know, said ki abhi thoda sa break le lo. Otherwise, they have never stopped me from playing any sport.
Yeah, I think 10th standard, obviously, हमारे यहाँ पे इट्स अ ह्यूज थिंग सो इट इज ऑब्वियस दैट यू एक्सपेक्ट योर पेरेंट्स इवन माय पेरेंट्स टोल्ड मी टू स्टॉप प्लेइंग क्रिकेट फॉर अ फ्यू डेज ऑल्दो आई हैड वॉलंटरली स्टॉप्ड बिफोर दैट बिकॉज़ आई फेल्ट यू नो इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर मी टू कंसंट्रेट अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ स्टडीज सो आई डिड दैट वॉलंटरली फॉर यू इट वाज दैट वे बट आई थिंक अदरवाइज इवन फॉर मी एंड यू नो आई हैव सीन यू आई थिंक देयर हैज बीन रियली गुड सपोर्ट बाय पेरेंट्स स्पेशली फ्रॉम आवर जनरेशन बिकॉज़ our generation yeah. of parents has seen the IPL come up big time. They've seen yes. football yes. grow in the Indian map. They've seen cricket grow up. So it's great for them to they have realized that maybe sport is another option
yeah.
for
yeah, another career option. Yeah, right.
Exactly. Yeah. So and if you have a passion for sport, there is nothing like it. It gives you so many life lessons along the way. And yes. it's just fantastic. And yeah. talking about experiences, one which I never had was to play a national level tournament. And for you, you have played a few. And how was your first experience? And which would you say was your best ever tournament on that national stage?
So, first time I played for nationals when I was in 9th standard. So, it was a good experience. Though I only played for like 45 minutes, but it was a really nice experience. I got to play with different state players and different state teams. So it was a really nice experience. After that only, I think I got to know the seriousness of the national tournaments because up till then, I used to think, we will go and play. But after that tournament, I really got into that seriousness, you know, that, yeah, I have to practice. I have to develop new skills and all. And talking about my favorite my tournament which has been I think in 11th standard I was the captain of Maharashtra team. I think that's the tournament I'll remember for my lifetime because I think that was the year when I was at my my performance was at peak. So it was in Jammu and especially so it wow. we will remember it for our life because we used to stay our hostel there from a few kilometers from there was an army camp and we used to hear okay. all those gunshots and all while practicing oh. so
okay.
it was we used to get goosebumps you know while practicing and all. So yeah, I'll remember that tournament for my till death for sure.
I think playing in Jammu in itself is fantastic yeah. because the weather, the scenic yeah. beauty, and then amongst that to do something that you love. I mean, that is one of the best feelings. Yeah. Although the gunshots don't really help in some terms.
No,
but you know, that's an experience. Yeah. That was a experience that takes you to reality. You know, there is a lot of beauty nearby, right. but there is also something that is going on in the same place. So, yeah. you know, it was a unique experience for you, obviously, to play.
Yeah.
Captain Maharashtra is, I think, it's something that you will yeah. cherish for your life. So, you know, that is something really fantastic, and we hope you keep going in those terms. And your football hasn't been always limited to just playing on the field. You have, you know, taken a lot of initiatives in, you know, being in other aspects of football as well. So we know for sure that you're a level 5 certified referee right now, and you have done refereeing courses with the AIFF and also with Premier League Skills. So could you just walk us through that?
So like coaching, there are you have to give exams, you have to be certified to coach for, to a certain level. So like that only, if you want to be a referee, you have to give some exams. So there are 5 levels. So first you have to go through level 5, then 4, then 3, 2, 1. So as a player, I wanted to, you know, discover like every corner of football. Like I wanted to discover coaching, refereeing. Like as an actor, you have want to discover everything, right? You want to discover, like you want to be a villain.
Genres,
in
yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah, I wanted to, and as a player, I think it is important to know all the rules and regulations of the sport, any sport if you're playing. So yeah, I think I was at the age that time that I wanted to, you know, be a referee. I really wanted to be a referee, but yeah, somewhere I had more interest in coaching and managing stuff, or managing related, you know, stuff. So yeah, I have given level 5 exam. So
yeah, so that is one tick in your box as well, you know. It's a little difficult because in terms of players actually wanting to understand each and every goal, because as a player you sometimes do not know most of them.
Yes,
which you probably think you know. So that is really important for a player to develop that knowledge of the game, and then you also understand.
Yeah, every year there is a new rule coming, you know. Some players also, they don't even know what rule is there, what rules have been changing every year. So you have to be up to date with the rules, right? So that's important,
And I think you also get a referee's perspective of certain fouls with the referee gives, and you're not happy about it. And then you
most important thing.
You went it out on the ref, and then if you start doing that, you understand, oh, wait, even I'm a referee, I would have given this one. Okay, fine. Let's just carry on. So, you know, in those terms, it really helps. You know, you've been, as you said, you've represented Maharashtra. You've done a lot of good work in Kolhapur, in your native city. And obviously, you've worked with AIFF as well recently. So, how are these federations actually help in your sport, and you want to know more about how your Kolhapur district has really helped you out in the federation?
So AIFF, All India Football Federation, is our is the national body of football in India. So they are doing tremendous job in, you know, growing football in India. And I think in last few years, football is like growing big time in India, right?
Yeah.
So yeah, they organize tournaments for women, women's teams, and they also organize IWL, which has been a big success, I think, for girls who play football. It's like a huge, you know, opportunity to showcase their talent. And yeah, it's very important job they are doing. And Kolhapur Sports Association is also working really good on in every sport, and in football, though, Kolhapur is known for football and Mahalakshmi and their, you know, chappals. So football, being football is main game of Kolhapur. Kolhapur Sports Association is working really well, though it's sad that this was the time when we used to play different kind of types of tournaments, but now we are sitting at home But I'm sure after this lockdown, some big tournaments will happen for women football.
Yeah, I think I'm betting it will happen because the IWL, as you said, was an instant success. It was a fantastic experience. And, you know, especially after Bala Devi's move to Rangers, I think a lot of emphasis has been also captured by women's football. AIFF does a lot of good work in the baby leagues, you know, where there are mixed gender matches or there are women's matches are being held at constant intervals. And, you know, it would have been difficult to, you know, get you here if you were playing the regular season. So, in a way, we are slightly, you know, just a little tad thankful that, you know, we could get you here, that you were that you had a little bit more time for us now. So, that worked out well for us, in a way. And coming to one of your, one of the things in football that is really dear to you, that is grassroots development. You've taken some steps in that direction. And you obviously want to be a coach, you want to do something in that sector, you want to develop grassroots sports within India. So I'm leaving the floor to you, and how do you think it shapes up in the future, and what would your role be in that?
So I think the grassroots development is very important in every sport. And in when we talk about grassroots development, I think a kid should start playing at the age of 6 or 7, any sport. It can be any sport, right? So if a kid will start playing at the age of 12 or 11, imagine the difference between a child who has started playing at the age of 6 or 7 and who has started playing at the age of 11 or 12. Imagine their the difference between their, you know, decision making power or the time that kid gets to you know, discover himself, herself as a human being, as a player. He gets to discover new skills, gets to work on their skill, their performance and all. So I think important to start playing any sport at a young age, as young as possible, because even because of that, a boy or a girl gets to know if he or she is really interested in that sport or even interested in any sport, right? So they get to get that much time to decide, right? And I think that's the age where our brain is at its peak, when it wants to discover everything, right, in every sector. So I think it's very important to start any sport at the age of 6, 7 or even earlier, that if possible. So I think when I see grassroots development in India, it's happening big time in football, at least, because I see so many leagues and camps going on for under 10 and under 12 year old children. AIFF is organizing baby league, as you said. Also, ISL clubs and I-League clubs are, you know, contributing in grassroots development big time. So the only thing is, I see so many boys on the ground in the category of under 10 and under 12, and I see very few girls on the ground, right? So I think here, as a parents, they should take responsibility to develop, or you know, to put their children into any sport. It doesn't matter, even if it's not football, in any sport, because it gives us, you know, opportunity to discover ourselves as a human. It, you know, there are so many qualities a sportsman can, you know, achieve, you know, playing any sport. So I think,
I think as a kid, if you follow a sport, if you play a sport, there are certain traits, like, you know, you never give up. You're always focused on what you want to do.
So
within
many
the span
qualities
of the game.
You discover,
And you discover being humble, because on your day you can be the best, but on your worst day you can totally be the worst. So you discover what it is
how
to be
handle
humble.
Failure
discover,
and how to handle your, so It's very important.
These are kind of things that you learn through sport, which is, I think it's just not just about sport, but it's about, you know, developing yourself as a human being. And, you know, that is what really helps. So one quick question for you. So this is something which I just thought of, and we've seen in the last few years, as you said, now that we need to have more women in football and in other sports as well, because, you know, any sport, no matter what happens, if the women get to the ground, I think they are doing really well. You see in badminton, the likes of PV Sindhu, Saina have done really well. In cricket now, we are seeing Smriti Mandhana, we are seeing Harmanpreet Kaur, we have seen a lot of stars before that as well. We are seeing now on the football field as well that we are getting some really good talented players on the field now. So the IWL is obviously kicking off big time, and there are a lot of foreign clubs who have recently invested in the ISL. Borussia Dortmund came to Hyderabad recently, and Mumbai City FC is now being taken over by City Football Group. They have a controlling stake now. So do you expect now with these ISL clubs really getting into the groove as try to work as professionally and as and to the European standard, which is probably football's most elite continent? So do you expect now with these clubs coming in, the women's football getting even more recognition? Because, you know, the likes of Dortmund or even your Man United, Olympic Lyonnais, PSG, Real Madrid, they have these women's teams who are doing really well continentally as well. So do you expect now with these people coming in, a lot of women's football to develop even further in India?
Yes, for sure. Because now I think the IFF has a rule to every I-League team should have a girls team. I think it's a new rule that has been Am I right? So I think it will help for sure to for women's football in India, and also because of the ISL and I-League, because of the investments, foreign investments in I-League and ISL, I think also women footballers will get more exposure, or they will see the new opportunities which are there and who are not, you know, who don't know how to make their career in football. I think they will find some way, you know, to make football as a career in their life, I think. Yeah, so it will help for sure.
Yeah, I really hope that it helps, and to see the men's and the women's team both someday on the World Cup stage is the ultimate dream, isn't it? So, you know, we are taking baby steps towards it now, and we hope to get better and better every day and every year with our football. So thank you, Mridul, for joining. You're probably one of the best, probably one of the most humble and the best persons I know who's played women's football. And it's been great to be a part of this conversation. And it's safe to say, with people like you invested into the sport, it looks like the beloved, beautiful game which we have is going on the right track. It's taking the right steps. And we are proud of your achievements. And we hope you keep making even more achievements in the future. And, you know, hopefully someday we see you, you know, we will be the first ones to actually take your interview as the manager of the Indian football team, hopefully. So let's hope that we'll be the first ones, by the way, we are taking it. So thank you. Thank you, Mridul, for joining. And thank you to all our viewers at The Sports to End. This was a great conversation, and we're looking to even more further exciting times ahead. Cheers.